Another beautiful day in the world of Terraria. You may notice some things look a little different around here. I, for the first time, have invested in the wondrous world of painting in Terraria, and I went away and, yeah, painted a lot of stuff pink, apparently including this, which I didn't realize until just now. In any case, I am Kirkyhee. These seagulls are loud AF. Shut up, shut up, shut up. And this is Terraria, where today we do I just wanted to show this off a little more, but we do have some stuff we need to get done. We want to take on the queen bee with any luck. I wanted to show off this whole area, the whole way I made this. This was opened, as you guys know, before, so I planted some leaves along there, put some sticks. This one wasn't mine, it was already like that, so I just now realized how ugly that looks because it's not connected to anything. But we have the trees connecting. It looks like the branches, the leaves have interwoven. Taken on that, we have a spot for our trophies, or our statues and our trophies. And if need be, I don't know. I never really thought this one ahead. I don't think I'll be getting too many statues, so I don't worry about it too awful much. But since we saw our good friend... Oh, he's here for once. Oops, sorry, seagull. Not really, though, because you're kind of annoying. What are you selling today, friend? You are selling something I already have in the DPS Bedazzled Nectar. Summons a pet butterfly. Oh, I wish I could afford one platinum. Actually, with the grinding, it's not too far off. What's an Esty? I don't know what an Esty is. Either way, we do have some goals we need to achieve, so in order to achieve said goals, we need to head into the jungle, where I better get my zoom out just a little bit, and we've actually got to take a quick moment. Okay, so this right here is where we're going to be looking to go, and obviously I'm going to have to carve this out a little bit and make a little bit of an arena. I don't think we'll get the queen on the first try. I'm going to give it my best. I'm obviously going to be using buffs at this point, so we'll hope that it works out. Oh man, I should have just went over to the left and used the actual entrance. Actually, no. We'd be better off going this way, because this way actually leads there. What is hurting my magic? Doesn't matter. I mean, it's reducing damage from... Oh, these, no doubt. Oh, restores mana with damage. Oh! I made those off camera. I didn't even realize it until now. But we had a blood moon while I was making some, or while I was fishing. So I decided to go ahead and... Damn it! I wasn't actually planning on recording this tonight. And yes, I am saying tonight because it is currently 1 a.m. I was going to record... Should I spoil it here? I wanted it to be a surprise. Well, you know what? There's only like a handful of you watching, so you will be in the know on something that's coming up on the channel, and it's something I think a lot of you will like. It's a new maker. Well, I say new, but it's, in all reality, in all honesty, it's like 2 years old at this point. But it's something that, it's gained popularity just recently. It's called, why and how is this blocked off? It's called Super Mario Maker World Editor, or World Engine, my mistake. Which, where am I going? That ain't the way I need to go. But the whole setup for it is, yeah, it's basically Mario Maker on PC and Android. So if you're interested in something like that, stay tuned to the channel. I might be making a stage for it, and then I will put that out there so you can go through it if you want to. And I actually think there's an update that has added, where am I going again? Oh, down this way. There's been a recent update that's added server options, apparently. So it's sort of like Mega Man Maker in that way, meaning, yeah, we could actually you could actually send me levels and I could play them. Probably fail at them because I'm not all that great at Mario Maker, if I'm to be honest. Okay, took us a hot minute, but we are here. This area worries me a little bit. So the first thing we need is obviously some platforms, which are way down here. Why do they always have to be at the bottom? And before we get too far along, I do want to point out, yeah, we're going to need to cut this area open by a lot. For sure we will. But before we get too far, I do want to point something out. So I got to switch over to me for just a second, which I think is 7. Hey! I have a new mouse, as you can see. It's another vertical mouse. It sets like this. This part I hate on it, but what can you do? It's used like this, much like the other one. But this one, unlike others, as you can see, there's a spot through here. I guess it's to reduce weight because it uses a battery. But I'm not sure. Thankfully, I have rechargeable batteries, so I should never have to worry about it not working quickly or running out too quickly. Okay, sorry about that. I will cut all the stuff out where I was talking and you could see nothing. So what I was basically saying was, ooh, coffee. It was coffee too. I'm guessing the drop rates must be considerably higher like this. But with the new mouse, I do expect to lose a lot today because I've had it for a whopping one day. I don't expect to last very long with it. I'm not used to it yet. It's very awkward to handle. It forces me to grip the mouse way deep. And that forces me to press the buttons in an awkward way, which isn't very pleasant at all. So, if we die, we know what to blame. It's not just going to be my bad gameplay skills. It's going to actually partially fall on this mouse because it handles considerably different than the other one. So today's focus, I think, is mainly going to be on the Queen Bee. Just thinking about the thumbnail. I can't wait for you guys to see the special surprise I have with her. It's nothing like super amazing. I think it does switch the way she attacks, so that could be interesting. But other than that, I don't think it's anything too drastic. Well, no. That's a lie. She will, if it works anyway, she will look drastically different. I teased it a little bit in the last part. I'm curious if anyone has figured out what it might be from the hint of gotta catch them all. That should have been a dead giveaway for anyone, but I'm really curious if anyone actually caught on to what that was supposed to be. So yeah, also talking about that special thing, Super Mario Maker World Engine, get out of here, bees. That is something that I do plan on playing on the channel, provided I can. It recently got discovered by a lot of people, thanks to a bigger YouTuber covering it. So, their site's been pretty overloaded. So, I couldn't actively play that like I wanted to tonight. I was going to, as I mentioned before, make a stage for you guys. I'm no good at making stages, so it probably would have been something really basic, like a run from start to finish type thing within a time limit or something like that. You know, it wouldn't have been too complicated. Please don't, oh my god, that's so stressful to watch. Please don't hit that out down there. I am begging you. If you hit that out, I am going to rage. My weapon almost hit it. That was scary. Oh my god, bees, go to hell. So I know what you're thinking right now. What exactly do you plan to fight the Queen Bee with? Well, I figure that should be obvious. Get up here, you jerk. We're gonna be going all out with this. We're going with the ball of hurt. I'm curious to see if it can be done. I don't see any reasons why it shouldn't be doable like this. But, you know, I've never taken out the Queen Bee with a melee weapon before. So why would that go like that? Whatever. This isn't the biggest arena out there. Why did I fall through there? Did I maybe fall through here somehow? No, I don't fully get it. Oh, well, we're full health in any case, so. Do we have everything going that we need to get going? I think we do. We'll use our handy dandy money trough. Let's actually favorite this so I don't ever accidentally get rid of it. And we will quick stack our moolah. And, oh boy. Let's do this. Come on, my queen. I hear her. Oh my god, she's tiny too. Everything's so tiny. So here's my thought patterns with it. Oh boy. So I don't know how well you can see her, but yeah, she has a pretty unique look. She's a Pokemon I don't recognize. That's the best way for me to say this. Yeah, this is exactly what I wanted. This is why I thought I might stand a chance with this. Especially when she gets shooting the bees off. I should, in theory, calm down. I haven't used my buffs yet. Oh, that have the damage. I want to see. Oh yeah, she can't get near us. She can't get near us with the bees. I'm forgetting to actively attack her though, is the problem. Can't rely on Mr. Flinks to do the job for us because we know that's just not happening. There we are. She's going to be really hard where she's this tiny. I can't actively get a bead on her. I might actually have to zoom in a little bit. This is really hard to hit with too, I'm now realizing. If I can get my health back up though, we might stand a chance. Yeah, keep coming at me. Keep coming at me, my queen. Alright, yeah. Bring your bees my way. You can't touch me with your damn bees. You can touch me with that stuff though. I forgot you shoot that at while you're going with your bees. Oh boy. This could be a long fight. I was gonna say, I have no idea where she is. I couldn't see her for the map. Okay. She coming back through? She coming back through? Oh! Well, it did say that her attack pattern's supposedly a little different, which I feel like it probably is. I don't know for sure. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Does she seem different than normal with the way she's attacking? I feel like she's not staying into the spot where she shoots the bees out for nearly as long as I'm used to. And she's not charging as much. Come on, spin this wheel. I was really relying on the charging, so she charged through the... It's not massive damage by any means, but it's damage all the same. One thing I do like with this texture mod, I think it changes... Oh, you know what I could have done that would have been really smart? I could have left a couple of blocks up there to try to set this on when she's up high. And that would have given her something... Since she can fly through the blocks, right? So that would have given her something to attack through. Oh, yeah. Come down here a little lower. I like this. This is looking to be a long fight until I get impatient with this and inevitably give up and switch over to my gun, which is bound to happen sooner or later. My god, I am doing a stellar job evading these. I know, guys, don't have to tell me. Thank you for finally stopping. Yeah, come down this way, then I can just get over here close to her and wail on her. Now we've got ourselves a plan of action. Really, I thought I was going to clear that. Little bees got me there, I think. Oof. Okay, we need to focus heavy on evading and healing right now. Because we need some huge time heals. We need to get our heals on big time here. Oh boy. I will say, if you do happen to enjoy this video and you're new here and you want to help me on my way, 2.5k subs, we're actually really close now. Subscribe with the button down below. I truly appreciate that. I know I'm not the most energetic, enthusiastic, interesting YouTuber as far as stories go, but I'm hoping my mediocre gaming skills make up for that. That's the truth, right? God damn it, bee! You're not making things easier, and I don't mean the queen bee in that instance. That little bum was really pushing me all around heavy. Let's get over on this side of her. Come down low. Yeah, come down a little lower, please. You know what? This is working. This is actually... Oh, damn. Come on, stay out there, please. Oh, god damn it, little bee! Flinks, you're not cutting it now either, friend. I may have to upgrade you. What could I upgrade to for a summon at this point? The bees? The bees would be an upgrade. I could actually go get the imp staff. But on all honesty, I'm not really a fan of the imp staff. Like, don't get me wrong, the damage is pretty decent with it, but damage aside, it's still not the greatest weapon. My god, this fight drags on for days if you don't actively, have something to hit her with constantly. Oh my god. Although when I do hit her, it's decent-ish damage, like 31's not too bad. Alright, once again, come down this way, my queen. I didn't mean like this. Get away from me, you annoying bees! If I could do what I did- oh boy, she just- ah, damn it! A little bee got me there. Flinx, could you at least deal with the bees for me, please? Give me a break! You wanna come down here a little more, queen? My queen, please? Once again, this is not how the queen bee would normally look. We are using a texture pack for this. Although I don't feel like you guys are dense and you realize this, so... I want to be sure for anyone that might be new to Terraria in general. And it's like, ooh, the queen bee looks pretty cool. Then they go to play it and see something completely different and be let down. Like, I don't want to be the result of that, so I'm doing my best to wow, the bees are getting a little tougher. At least it seemed like it. She's shooting her little buttholes a little faster there, too. Caught a lot of bees in there with the honey. Oh my god, we have only got her to half health, guys! This is lasting for too long! Yeah, stay there. Nope, she had to move. She's like, nope, I'm taking too much damage. I want nothing to do with this fight. Well, now you know how I feel, Queenie. Now you know how I feel. I wish I had potions that were healing 100. I wish I had them on me. It's probably better. I do have some. I just didn't friggin' bring them with me is the problem. You know, I should just sit right up in her like that. Or right up beside her, anyway. So, fun fact. This fight here apparently is one that Chippy has a really hard time with. Chippy from Chippy Gaming. Hello, my name's James and all that. Which, I don't understand why. I mean, it is a pretty basic fight, as you're seeing. I've come close to dying a couple times, but I've not been in any real serious danger. The fight is only half over, obviously, so she is going to get harder yet. She'll get it at one point, so she's charging at us almost constantly. And that is where this will really come in handy, you see. That is why I want to use this. This episode is going to be like a 40-minute queen bee fight. If I remember, I will put the whatever the queen bee's name is here. Or whatever the Pokemon's name is for the queen bee. I will add that probably in the title, if anything. Come after me, my queen. Oh boy, you are coming after me a lot faster. Oh, no. I need that little bee gone. I need that bee gone. Be gone, bee! There we are. Damn, it skewered me! You know what? That's not fine. Damn it. This is the only hive we had. Okay. New plan. I gotta figure out how to make the abomination thing. And we're using the damn gun. We gave it a valiant effort like that. I feel like that was a well worthwhile venture. But in the end, this is not going to cut it. All right. One more dip down into the ether for good luck. Let's do this. Like I said, this time I am going all out. Oh, these ricochet too. So I'll be going all out on her by fighting with a flipping gun. Let's get this out of the way once again so I can see what I'm doing a little better. I do wish he was a little bigger so we could... And I hit the wrong thing. There we are. I do wish he was a little bigger so we could see her better. We could just... Ah, damn. She didn't stay there very long. Next time she stops up, I'll stop shooting her for a little bit so we can zoom in here and get a better look at her. So here's... Link! Come on, dude! You know what? That's fine. We'll stay fighting zoomed in. That's fine. I don't need to be able to see. Out of here, bees. There's a nice good look at her. That's pretty cool. Wait, does she seriously not hit you when you're directly below her? I feel like we've discovered this before, though. I gotta zoom back out so I can actually see what I'm doing. But this fight should go a little cleaner this time, as long as I don't get too cocky about it and, you know, die again, get too careless, however you want to say it. I've only got one, or I don't have any more potions on me, so I really don't want to have to deal with getting potions again. But I'm probably going to have to deal with getting potions again, because I don't expect to beat her in just a try or two. Yeah, keep farting your bees at me. I love it when you fart your bees at me. Meteor shot. I don't think I've used it very often, but my god, this stuff is potent as beans. Is it just me? It could just be me, I don't know. But is it just me, or is this seed, like, easier than a normal master mode? Maybe I've just gotten that much better at Terraria, I don't know. I highly doubt it, I have died a lot, but compared to my first romp in master mode, I am doing peachy keen when you get right to it. Yes, I am from the 60s, get over it. I'm actually not, I'm from the 80s. I was born in the 80s, 1983, being a precise date. A more precise date. A precise year. Break off, bee! Can you imagine shooting just... Like, queen bee's one thing. She's the size of... This queen bee, anyway, is the size of a person. But could you imagine fighting or taking down a bee flying through the air with a gun? That's a special task in and of itself. I'm glad I have the extra jump, it saved me. I think one thing we'll have to do after this is go to the sky. We haven't gone through all the sky islands yet. That's something I should have done long ago. I have 3 gravity potions. So I think that's how we'll end the video off, actually. Tear through her. Although at this point, do we even need anything from the sky? Well, we plan to make the zenith, we do. I suppose, anyway. So I've also got to ask while I'm here, anyone that plays Terraria, have you tried the 1.4 T-Mod loader yet? I have it downloaded, and maybe I'll do a run with it, but it is in an alpha, and they tell you straight up that if you aren't using it as a modder, as someone creating mods, sorry about that, it is something that will be prone to breaking as it's updated, so, you know, that's one thing to keep in mind. But once 1.4 gets fully implemented with the mod loader, I think that'll probably be the only way I ever play it again. Because could you imagine? Like, take the Calamity mod or any of the really big mods. I would love to try some of them in T-Mod Loader with 1.4, with the benefits of 1.4. I have the only mod, in actuality, I've ever went through completely is, what was it? It was one that my cousin and I went through. It was the Thorium mod, if I'm not mistaken. And the end fight was pretty wild in that. It was very hard with 2 people because this game, going through it for the first time, well, you guys saw it with 1.3.5, I think I went through with my first run on expert mode, and then I went through it again in 1.4 master mode. See this? When she gets going back and forth like that, that's neat when I need to get my other thing down because she gets really fast with it. If it feels like I'm getting really lucky getting between the stingers, no, that's not luck. Well, I got caught on a bee there. But it's not luck. It's because these stingers are so visible, thanks to this mod, I'm actually able to see them, to evade them a lot more. Come on. You're damn near there, Queenie. You are damn near there. Oh, boy. So here's the trick. A lot of people have problems with Queen Bee in her last phase when she gets dashing back and forth fast like that. When she dashes, you dash. Dash into her, but she can't hurt you. Obviously, you need the Shield of Cthulhu on for this. but you're practically invulnerable here. This is the easiest part of this fight by far. This is something I figured out, oh god, ages ago with her. Like, back when I played this on the PS3, I think that's when... No, Shield of Cthulhu may not have been a thing back then. I don't think we ever beat it on console. So it could have been when I first bought it on PC. I think it was in the 1.3 era then. But, yeah, just dodging into her does wonders. When she gets going really fast like this, it's really hard to do, as you can see there, but it is doable, provided you don't miss. Oh boy, she rendered me useless there at the end, though. Oh my gosh, she was going a little too fast. So the best way that would work then, dodge, jump, dodge, jump, dodge, jump. That's fine. I will beat her before this video is done. I'll bring you back near the end of the fight. Well, tip munchers, what the hell just hit me? I forgot to friggin' bring potions. You know what? That's fine. Oh, god damn it. That might not be fine. There's a lot of enemies here. That's fine. We'll make it work. Okay, we're getting pretty close here at this point. She's down roughly where she was before. So I'm taking the more cautious approach of not dodging into her constantly, but only when I absolutely have to. Ooh, she never left me an opening to get through there, guys. Oh, I missed my opening there. So, you gotta remember, I'm fighting her without buffs right now as well, so... that's making things a little trickier. I've been having to do this a lot, too, switching over to that to keep myself a little safer during the time that she pushed out her little bees. There she is. That's annoying me, though. I'm not sure what's causing it to switch over to weapon one when I'm not hitting anything for it. I may need to put my gun there since that keeps happening. I don't know whether it's my mouse is getting stuck in half turn or what the deal is. But something is causing some weird funky issues there. Ooh, I never jumped quite high enough on that one. Come on. Get out of here, bee. Here's the only time I get any real damage on her, too. If I don't win this fight, I will put the height of the arena up, because I'm sure you've noticed by now. The arena's not quite high enough. There's times she's up into the ceiling where I can't hit her, which is not giving us any help, not doing us any favors. Ooh, there was apparently a hit. Oh, God. What? Where'd she go? Oh, there she is. She just took off. She needed out of here for a moment. She's like, I need a breather. I'm starting to feel this fight. Queen, I know how you feel. Screw you. I was holding the button in to shoot, but I wasn't focusing on oh my god, these are getting so fast. I was not focusing on shooting in that moment. That's all I can say. I was focusing on saving my life by evading everything I possibly could. Okay, down, up, up, dodge. Dodge one more up, and I should really stop shooting in those moments when she's doing that, because I'm not having any luck hitting her, right? Screw you, queen. Screw you, my queen. Screw you all night long. I'm not letting this fight go your way. I will be annoyed if I beat her without the buffs when I couldn't beat her with the buffs. Okay. Oh, you sneaky little thing. She has, like, less than 100 health. A hair over 100 health. She's mine. She's mine. I can't lose. Ha 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 ha. Sparkling honey? What are you? Summon the honeybee. Oh, okay. So this is one of the things that changed. Where's our honeybee? It's not working. We'll put it on like that. There we are. Oh my god. Oh my god, let me get in and see that. That is also a Pokemon, I'm assuming. Oh my god. Is there a Pokemon that's a honeycomb? How out of touch am I with Pokemon? Whew, that was a fight and a half. Whew, thumbs up and subscribe for that one, guys. My left hand legitimately hurts right now. But we're not done yet. I know we've seen the main event of the video anyway, but we've got to do this. You can't leave before you lay down the trophy in the order that you got them. Queen Bee before Skeletron. I think that's a first for me. Don't go look at the other series because I think I did the same thing in that too. Oh, four bosses down. Now all we have is Skeletron and the Wall of Flesh. Six episodes in and we are nearly out of hard mode, out of normal mode. But next time around, we probably won't be facing a boss. Next time around, let's see what we got, by the way. Oh, oh wait, no, I'm not disappointed. This is what I was going for. This is what I wanted. Oh, thank you, YouTube Lock. Apparently it is a thing for this run. Okay, so I'm not putting that on. I'm sorry, I'm just not. So we will need to make the bee armor, which I think the bee wax goes into. Am I right, Cole? I don't know if your name was Cole. Okay, so how many are we gonna need? 10, 22, 30. Fart Nuggets, I got a beater again? Oh, they hate me. They hate me, guys. Why do they hate me so? Oh, well, I got something to do off camera now. But we are going to be pushing over toward the bees. I'm fairly certain. Yeah, I'm fairly certain that makes things a little... Why am I tossing those? I can sell them and at least get a little money back. But I'm fairly certain that moving that... Maybe it's just putting this on. Increases the strength of friendly bees. Yeah, that's all I need. The bee armors for extra summons. I don't think we need to go to the summoners class. Oh my god, I didn't even put my armor worm scarf on! I had fishing line on! Oh, you idiot. You idiot! Oh, I feel so stupid. Whatever. We need to find... Well, I think that's determined we don't need the armored worm scarf. So, yeah. We'll be a little bit stronger with our friendly bees. We have our bee Pokemon with us. Oh my god. That thing's kind of adorable. Seriously, look at it. I don't know what it is. Look at it blink. I don't know why I'm so fascinated by this thing. It's got to be a newer Pokemon. It's got to be. Let me know if you know what it is in the comments down below, guys. I truly appreciate that. But yeah, I think this is a pretty good spot to end it. I will fight the Queen Bee again on my own time off screen, just so you guys don't have to suffer through it. And in the next part, we'll go looking for a mushroom biome. I think I know where there is one. It's just I want to make more of these potions worth 100. And then, yeah, I think take on Skeletron and explore the dungeon. Boy, that'll be fun. Fun, he says. Fun. In any case, guys, if you did happen to enjoy this video, oh yeah, I did want to ask, what do you think of the new arrangements I made here? I did just make stuff pink, as I mentioned before, but I like it. I like it because it blends in, feels like it's a natural part of the world, right? Oops, sorry. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below what you think of this. On top of that, you want to help me on my way once again, 2.5k subs, subscribe with that button down below, guys. Truly, truly appreciate it. Check out these videos off to the side now they've appeared. And yeah, I did say we were going to take in looking through the skies. We'll do that in the next part. Remind me in the comments down below. All right, see you in the next one.